Good morning, Cedar River Elementary School. Today is Wednesday. It is August 26th. Here are today's announcements. Let's see her. We had our general PTO meeting on Monday, more like a town hall edition, so your families were able to ask some questions about remote learning. I think I can issue a little bit of information to you as well. There's going to be times during your day where you are live with your teacher, where you are in a Zoom call, similar to what Mrs. Cassidy and Mrs. Rodriguez look like on Monday when I introduced them. And you will get to interact with your teacher. Now, some of it is what we call asynchronous learning. It's a big word, but what asynchronous means is that you'll have some work that you'll do on your own time. Now, own time doesn't mean like 2 weeks from now. It means during the school day, like when you would be working at your desk completing an assignment. And so you'll get that work from your teacher. Now, there are other times when you might watch a video or of your teacher or PE or art or however that happens to be, and you'll get that instruction through that way. Just a little bit of what your day might look like through that learning. And then later in the day, you'll have another opportunity to be in a small group with your teacher and maybe a few other students, or maybe just a one-to-one conversation so that you can talk about your writing or your math or any questions that you might have. So, does this look different than normal school? Yeah, it does. But I can promise you that your teachers are working really hard to make it engaging and fun and have opportunities for you to ask questions and to work with your friends and to really, really be in school, because even though we're not all together, we're still together working through this, right? I think so. We're trying hard. And I, on Friday, will be sending home a link about our new spiritware. This is our old spiritware, Cedar River. But on Friday, we have new spiritware that I hope that you'll get a chance to look at and love. I love it. I love the new one. And so you'll get the opportunity to order it through a link, and then it'll come to our school. And then when it comes to the school, we'll get it all packed and ready in our distribution days. Now, distribution days. There's been lots of questions about what that looks like. What kind of items are you getting from the school? And do you still need to get other school supplies? And how does that all work together? And the answer is yes and yes. Yes, you're going to get some things from school, including sticky notes and a whiteboard and a math journal and writing journals and a whiteboard marker and lots of things. And right now, this week, there are lots of people working in different shifts to socially distance in order to get all of those prepared for you. Some of those things are on back order, so they're not going to come all together. Now, do you still need supplies? You do. You'll still need some crayons and pencils and whatever your teacher has deemed important in addition to that district supply drop. How that is going to work is one day next week, not on the first day of school, you will get an opportunity to drive through around the school and pick up your supply packet. It's just going to be everyone's are the same per grade level. Then, in a few weeks from now, you'll get some stuff just for you from your teacher, from your grade, some other things that will help you in your education journey as we practice this remote learning. So that's a little bit of information. It doesn't give you a direct day yet because, to be honest, I don't know the exact day because I'm waiting on the supplies to come in. Everybody in Washington is ordering the same stuff. And so we want to make sure that the supplies that we get to you, we actually have them. Doesn't make sense to have to come through two times in 1 week when we're like, oh, we got the whiteboards. So we're doing our best to get all of those supplies together so you can pick them up on one day. And I promise your parents that we'll have a long window of time on that day in order to accommodate those of you that come early or those of you that can't come until later in the afternoon. So I hope that makes you feel a little bit better. It's not the first day of school, but it is the first week of school. Now, I have some introductions for you, and I can't wait for you to meet the rest of our fifth grade team.
Hey, fifth graders, welcome back. We are super excited to have you coming back to school, and we wanted to take a moment to introduce ourselves. I am Mrs. Nickel, and I teach fifth grade along
with... Hello, I'm Miss Nixich, and Mrs. Nickel and I will be teaching together this year. And we also have...
Hello, I am Miss Kalb, and I am the fifth grade discovery teacher this year.
Awesome. So we wanted to just kind of tell you a little bit about ourselves. So Miss Nixich, what'd you do this summer?
I love the sun, so I tried to be outside as much as I could. And one of my favorite things that I did this summer was I got to float on the Yakima River. We got in big old inner tubes and floated down, and there were some really cool rapids, and it was really warm out. So that was one of my favorite memories. And then I also built some planter boxes, and I planted some flowers that nice. I've been wanting to do for a long time. So those were my highlights of this summer. What about you, Mrs. Kalb? What did you do?
Well, this summer I spent a lot of time hiking around the Snoqualmie area. I also got a little more adventurous and did a lot of rock climbing. So I did rock climbing up in Snoqualmie in the North Bend area, but I also spent a week climbing in Maple Canyon in Utah and climbed some really high heights, learned a lot of new skills, and really pushed my limits with heights. But it was a lot of fun, and I'm glad I got to have those adventures. What about you, Mrs. Nickel?
Well, this summer, like my cohorts, a lot of time outside, a lot of time in national parks and hiking. We actually went on an adventure where we went to Yellowstone and Grand Tetons National Park when taking my daughter off to college. And then I've got another kiddo that's starting college this year as well. So a busy summer taking care of my family and then also being outside. So, on that note, we are so excited to see you next Tuesday, and
we can't wait to see all of you, and we hope that you've been enjoying your summer so far, but we are so happy that we get to start school again, and we can't wait to see you.
It's going to be a great year. We're excited. You're all excited. Let's make this thing happen.
Woohoo!
That is the rest of your fifth grade team. Now, a little bit of trivia, because I always like to share some of those tidbits with you. Miss Kalb was in my second grade class when I was a student teacher a million years ago, and now she's teaching at Cedar River. So I'm pretty excited to have her on board. I also asked Mrs. Nickel to not re-record the video. You'll notice that there was a little bit of an echo, and I did that on purpose because that might happen in your video. And sometimes that means that your sound is wonky or that you have it up to where you're too close to somebody else that might have their computer on as well. So you're getting that feedback. So I did it on purpose so that you can have a little bit of a tech lesson with the morning announcements that I have for you today. So, excitement for today. We have spirit wear coming your way on Friday. I've received some photos from some of you of what you've been doing this summer. Send them to me. Send them to me to this email address. Now, when you do, can you please put in the subject line summer photo so that I can sort through them? Unfortunately, one of the downfalls of being the dean is that I get lots of emails and I don't want to lose your photos in that shuffle, in that mix. So just title them summer photos and send them to me. I want to share them on Friday because you know what? School starts next week and I want to see your faces. I'm going to miss that bustling, but this is kind of me being a little bit selfish to get to see your face and your friends to see all the great things that you've done this summer. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today. I'm heading off to some new teacher meetings today and I'll be thinking about you, and I will see you here on Friday. Have a great Wednesday. Let's do some Wellness Wednesday. Get outside. Enjoy the sunshine. and